To control the atom with the Casper CG client, we first need to find the IP of the atom itself. I'm using the Atom Setup software to do this. Next, in the Casper CG client, click Edit, Mixer, add an atom. Let's call it the Atom 1. Sometimes you have several atoms in production, so it's good to name it that you can recognize it. In the address, put in the IP of the atom. In the tools, go to atom, select input, select the atom as server, and select the input you want. So for me, it's the media player, it's burger, and the atom Manchester, and if you press F2, it will go to the program of the atom. As you can see, there are several tools that you can use with the atom software, but I won't go into deep for this tutorial, but I will do an example. So we're selecting the atom again. I want to have VT. I have a VT server running with Casper CG with a 10-second clip of a video I made about a year ago. And the goal is to play out the video and then automatically switch after the video ends. So in this example, I'm gonna switch to black after the video. But first we need to know the length of the video in milliseconds. I'm using media info for this. I will link it in the description. So if I open the file, and go to custom view, you can see the total length in seconds and milliseconds. I fill this in for when I want to switch to the black source. And when I press F2, it plays out the clip on the program. And after the 12 seconds, it automatically switches to black. And that's a basic example how to use the Atom with the Casper CG client. But with macros, of course, you can do way more.